Welcome to our video on trigonometric integrals involving sine and cosine, part 1. And the goal is to determine trigonometric integrals involving powers of sine and cosine. What we're going to be doing is utilizing this Pythagorean identity to change the form of the integrand so that we can use u substitution to evaluate the integral. And notice that this is the same Pythagorean identity, it's just that here it's solved for sine and here it's solved for cosine. So we're going to take a look at three cases. Let's take a look at the first one. The first case is when the power of sine is odd. What we're going to do is save one factor of sine and convert the remaining factors to cosine. Now at first this may look intimidating, but essentially what's happening here is this sine has an odd power on it. What we're going to do is take this odd power of sine, save one factor of sine here, and leave the remaining even factors of sine here. And then we'll take the even powers of sine and convert them to 1 minus cosine squared. Then if we let u equal cosine x, here we'll have a bunch of 1 minus u squareds. Here we'll have a bunch of u's. And since du equals negative sine x dx, we can replace all of this here with negative du. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Since the power of sine is odd, we'll rewrite this and save one factor of sine. So we'll have sine squared x times cosine squared x times one factor of sine x, and of course dx. So we're going to convert this sine squared to 1 minus cosine squared x, and we'll address this extra factor of sine x in the next step. Now that we've converted everything into cosines except this one factor of sine x, we're going to let u equal cosine x, which means differential u will equal negative sine x dx. And if we solve this for sine x dx, we'll have negative du equals sine x dx. So now we can replace all of this with negative du. Here we'll have 1 minus u squared. And here we'll have u squared. So let's go ahead and rewrite this in terms of u. Let's go ahead and factor the negative out. Let's also distribute this u squared. So we'll have u to the second minus u to the fourth, and then du. So now we integrate this with respect to u, then replace u with cosine x. So applying the power rule, we'll have negative u to the third over 3. This will become plus u to the fifth over 5. Plus c. And our last step is to rewrite this in terms of cosine x. So this will be negative 1/3 cosine cubed x plus 1/5 cosine to the fifth x, and then plus c. This is a technique when the power of sine is odd. And we'll have a similar technique when cosine is odd. We'll save one factor of cosine and then convert the remaining factors to sines. If we take a look at the setup, if the power on cosine is odd, we'll save one factor of cosine, leaving an even power on cosine. And then we'll take these even powers of cosines and convert them to 1 minus sine squareds. Then once everything is in terms of sine except for this one extra factor of cosine, we'll let u equal sine x, so this would be u to the power of m times 1 minus u squared to the power of k, and then du is going to equal cosine x dx. All of this becomes du. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Again, we have an odd power of cosine, so we save one factor of cosine and then convert the rest to sines. So this will be cosine squared x times cosine x dx. Now we're going to replace cosine squared x with 1 minus sine squared x. And then we'll deal with this extra factor of cosine in the next step. So now that everything's in terms of sine, except for this extra factor of cosine, we'll let u equal sine x, and differential u will equal cosine x dx. So this will be u to the fourth, this will be 1 minus u squared, and all of this becomes du. So u to the fourth, 1 minus u squared, and again, cosine x dx is equal to du. Let's go ahead and distribute this. We'll have u to the fourth minus u to the sixth integrated with respect to u. So we'll have u to the fifth over 5 minus u to the seventh over 7 plus c. And now, since u is equal to sine x, we have 1/5 sine to the fifth x minus 1/7 sine to the seventh x. Then, of course, plus c. Now let's take a look at the third case. If the powers of sine and cosine are even and non-negative, we can make repeated use of the half-angle identities as we see here. Now you might be asking, what about when sine and cosine are both odd? Well, in that case, you can take your pick between the first two cases. Let's go and take a look at now when both powers are even. So again, notice both powers are even, so we'll take advantage of these half angle identities. We'll replace sine squared x with 1 minus cosine 2x divided by 2. We'll multiply this by 1 plus cosine 2x divided by 2. Notice we can factor out 1/4. When we multiply these together, these are conjugates, so we'll have 1 plus cosine 2x minus cosine 2x, that's 0, then we'll have minus cosine squared 2x. Now we can use the half angle identity again, so that we have 1/4 and then 1 minus this quantity here, but now since we have cosine squared 2x, we're going to have cosine 4x. If we were to take this and multiply it by 2 over 2, we could factor out another 1/2. So we'd have 1/8 times the integral of, this would be 2 minus 1, which would be 1, minus cosine 4x. Let's go ahead and take this over to the next screen. So if we integrate this, we'll have 1/8 times x minus, here we would have a u substitution where u is equal to 4x, so du is equal to 4 dx, dividing both sides by 4, we have a 1/4 du is equal to dx. So we'd have minus 1/4 the integral of cosine u, which would be sine u or sine 4x. And of course plus c. Let's go ahead and distribute the 1/8 and we'll call it good. We'll have 1/8 x minus 1 over 32 times sine 4x plus c. In part 2, we'll take a look at some more examples. I hope you found this helpful.